guess these guys are the star of the show, huh?
Turtles! I love turtles!
All right, who's our first volunteer? Sonneborn family.
Sonneborns.
Since 2007, a group of turtle-loving families have gathered along the shore of Lake Champlain to give a group of baby turtles a new lease on life. These turtle saviors are part of the Head Start program, created by a partnership between the Vermont Fish and Wildlife Department and the Echo Science Center.
Well, Echo's purpose is to really teach about the stewardship and caring about our Lake Champlain. Today is an example of bringing the stewardship message full circle, where we have families and people adopting a turtle, spiny softshell turtle, learning about it over the time that it's at Echo for the winter months, and then coming to the very area where it normally would have hatched and been free, but bringing it here for the first time to be free in Lake Champlain, where it's a little stronger, a little healthier, has a better chance of survival.
Money raised through the adoption process helps cover the cost of caring for the turtles during a 10-month growing period. Anyone can adopt a turtle.
We wrote a paper and we told it to the whole brownie troop. And so we raised enough money so we could adopt a softshell turtle.
In addition to over 40 spiny softshell turtles, a few dozen map turtles will also be released.
Let's face it, he's even smaller than an Oreo. What happens to Oreos? They're snacks.
Steve Parren, the Wildlife Diversity Program Director for the Vermont Fish and Wildlife Department, rescued these turtles during the previous fall. Saving these turtles is critical. With an estimation of less than 300 adult spiny softshell turtles in Lake Champlain, the species has been listed as threatened in Vermont since 1987. The two biggest threats to the turtle population are loss of nesting habitat along undisturbed gravel beaches and predation.
Before we had so much of the shoreline developed for people, beaches would come and go, you'd have a flood, a new deposit of gravel or sand, and the turtles would follow those. Now you've got seawalls and riprap and docks and infrastructure that prevents that from moving around. So I've got these few really incredibly important sites. And so I'm trying to mimic what nature would do in sort of an artificial way. I'm keeping them clear of vegetation, making sure they're sunlit. And then the other important piece is I've got all these predators that are very abundant along the shores of Lake Champlain.
In mid-July, after the turtles have laid their eggs, the nesting sites are covered with a wire mesh.
That's 1-inch by 2-inch mesh. And a baby turtle that hatches out and comes to the surface can go through that mesh. But a skunk or a raccoon trying to dig through it, it's not going to be worth its time.
Even with all of these precautions, these half-dollar-sized creatures are vulnerable to everything from great blue herons to bass and bullfrogs. With only 2% maturing to the breeding age of 12 years old, Echo's adoption program is giving a handful of turtles a head start to increase their odds of survival.
Bingo. Goodbye. Do you see them in there?
So there are over 20 families here today releasing what they believe are their turtles.
They're cute. It tickles.
To me, that really is a stewardship message in a nutshell, because the children learn, especially, that they start to care about an animal because they adopted it. They go to Echo and visit it over and over again because they're members and they want to see how it's doing. And then they learn that you need to let it be free. You need to let it go. So even though it's interesting to have a fish in a bowl or a turtle in an aquarium or something like that at home, really they belong in the wild. And really, once they're in the wild, what can you do to make sure that where they live is protected and safe and the water is clean?
Bye. Good luck, turtles.
Oh, yeah, I got a picture of Ellie. Is he going to go back out? Oh, there he goes.
Coming back.
He's coming back.
What we did today was try to bend the curve a little bit in their favor so that we would have more turtles living longer in that younger, more vulnerable age class. Once they get larger, there's really not a lot that's going to go wrong.
Do you want to just let him swim off your hand?
Oh, you have something.
He's going to think about it for a minute.
Oh, mine's ready to go.
From a biological standpoint, there are no other turtles here in Vermont that have soft shells. All other turtles have big, heavy armored shells. These guys have a piece of shoe leather for a shell, which is very unique.
Can you breathe in air?
Yep, turtles breathe air just like us.
This innovative project not only educates the community about these fascinating creatures, it also helps children and adults make a connection to the lake's ecosystem.
It's all part of our natural heritage. We belong here, but so do they, you know, and I think we can share the planet, and I think we owe it to the rest of life to honor them and to allow the natural world to continue.
Oh, good.
Yay! Good job, Dee!